Waiting long?
No. A couple of seconds. Where should we go?
Wherever you like.
No, I leave all that to you.
The place where we dance outdoors. We haven't gone there for ages.
Oh, great. And it's great weather, too. Well, then, princess, your carriage is waiting. Every time I think of this vacation when I won't see you, it puts me to bad humor. Don't go away, Dominique.
Stop begging me, Pablo. At home, I would never be forgiven if I stayed here during vacation.
You're cruel. I'll die without you.
You won't at all. Just stop and consider. We've been together nearly a year now since the day What's-Her-Name introduced us at the university.
I know that. And in your eyes, I don't mean a thing.
You do, my precious. You do. More than my family does, but try to understand. My family is set in its ways. It's almost a ritual, a reunion in Brittany about the family hearth. We're almost a feudal clan.
Come on. I never heard of these tribal habits of yours. I've heard that you Britons act more like ghosts than humans sometimes. But ghosts don't sit around a hearth. They only haunt deserted places, hmm?
I promise you. This will be the last time I ever let my family come between us. That I promise you.
I give in. You win. You win every time.
I'll get a plane ticket for the flight this coming Tuesday.
Why not?
Only 7 days. What's 1 week to us?
For me, it's a lot more. It'll be a week with 366 days.
I don't get it.
Because it'll be 7 days without you and leap year.
Thanks a lot.
Together for the rest of our lives with our child. Isn't that tremendous?
Is that all? That's the way women have thought ever since the world began. Don't take all the credit.
In other words, you don't think that it's important.
I do. But I'm worried about the practical problems. Is it Spanish or French child?
Spanish.
French, I say.
I want him to live like a Spaniard. Spaniards are nice. My feeling for them runs in the family. Why else would I be sent to school here? My father was wild about everything of yours. Isn't Spain the place for us? Hmm?
No, I'm not convinced it is. Brittany, with its thick fog and calm air. I'm enchanted with Brittany.
You're always trying to tease me.
I'll tell you. Let's be bound to a pact.
Tell me, Pablo.
If it's a girl, she's a French citizen. Because I go crazy over French girls. And if it's a boy...
A Spaniard. I'm in love with all the Spaniards I see.
Just with one.
I said I'm in love with all the Spaniards I see.
You're not.
Prove it. My weakness is cemeteries, you know. Do you like them?
I hate them.
Do they frighten you?
Well, no, it's... because for me, they've no attraction.
You must agree that's a rare attitude among you Spaniards. Their favorite entertainment's a game with death. They like the moment of truth.
There are lots of us who don't. We don't like bullfights or death any more than lots of strangers do.
I'm attracted.
To bullfights?
No, I meant to death. I've always thought it the state of perfection for all men.
Well, thanks.
Not you, of course. I think death is good to a person. And death is kind. I like its peace. And its mystery, too.
Nobody would doubt that you're from Brittany, but it's just the same, I think, as in our Galicia. The pretty girls are necromancers.
What are they?
Witches.
Oh, yes. All the girls in Brittany, when they're born, are more or less witches.
Well, let's go. We've seen the cemetery now. I think we'd better get out of here. I don't feel comfortable
Pablo,
in these... What?
Do you love me?
Well, why should you ask that? You know very well. Let's go. Come on now.
Tell me so.
I'll tell you that, but under some tree or in a clover or even in the middle of a flock of sheep. Because here I won't. Please forgive me, Dominique. I just can't explain it.
Tell me you do. And tell me right this minute. Right here. While we're surrounded by the most important and the most enduring things that exist in the whole world. Love and death. We cannot lie. Not in their presence. Do you love me?
Yes, I love you.
Will you always?
I will, Dominique. This is utter nonsense. You know that I love you.
Tell me you love me after death.
Why should I say that?
I want to hear you say that you'll go on loving me beyond the end of mortality.
Can you?
Yes, someplace. Somewhere.
Are you sure you can? Mm-hmm. If that's true, you must have known my love for you could never end. In this life or beyond it. Although, I tell you now, I told myself the moment I saw you in class that day, and I did, I said that blonde little French girl is for me, and mine until doomsday. So far, it's just as I said. You knew this.
This is consecrated ground. Promise me one other thing.
Promise you what?
The first one who dies must come back to Earth from the beyond. Repeat it.
The first one who dies must come back to Earth from the beyond.
And prepare the other one for the hereafter.
And prepare the other one for the hereafter.
I swear it.
I swear it. Write me?
Every day.
I'll phone you every other day.
What will you eat on? Your allowance won't pay for both.
I'll tell my parents I'm sick or something.
You'll have to think of something that takes expensive medicines.
I already have. I'm sick with love.
It's not worth the trouble to make up strange stories. I'll only be away for a week, just long enough to get the papers in order. You have your work to do here. Line up the wedding march, a pretty little chapel with flowers on the altar. I'll take care of the license and all that.
Anything else?
Yes, I'll produce the bride. I promise she won't be one day later than she has to be.
A man and a woman.
Are you there? Look here, tell me the name of the woman, if you will, please. Are you there? Hello?
Yes, senor.
If you please, senorita, I want to know the name of the woman who survived the crash. If she's my fiancée.
I'm sorry, senor. The reports are still confused and we don't have any exact information for you. If you'd like to give me the name and address of your fiancée, send you the information as soon as we know.
Yes, yes, of course. Her name is Dominique. Dominique Monceau. I'd appreciate it if you could.
I understand, senor. May I have your name and address, please?
Forgive me. Pablo Velasco. Yes, hello? Hello?
The Court of France, Signor. Hold the line, please. I'm sorry, but your party doesn't answer.
Don Pablo.
Thank you. But I can't sleep without knowing for sure.
I understand, but you know the old saying, no news is good news.
Sick with fear. You're not hurt. You're all right. Yes, yes. Obviously, you're all right. Dominique, I love you.
I love you, Dominique. Can you hear me? Dominique, say something.
Yes, I'm fine. And by the way, you sound better than you. When did you hear the news?
By a strange coincidence, I had a vision of it all. I nearly went crazy with suspense.
Had a vision?
I can't explain it to you right this minute. Dominique, I can take the first flight out. And I want to be there with you, to have you near me. I want to see with my eyes that you're not hurt at all.
You needn't fly here to find out. In a day or two at the latest, I'll be there with you, Pablo. I'll be in Madrid on Friday. We can meet at the usual place.
Friday, I'll be wedding a Barajas at the airport.
Not the air terminal, darling. I want to look my nicest for you when we see each other. I'll be expecting you on our bench in the park. We'll pretend nothing has happened. We'll pretend nothing happened to worry you. We'll pretend we were never as much as separated a day, Pablo.
Dominique.
Yes?
You weren't injured at all in the plane crash. Tell me you're just as pretty as ever, that you're all together.
Of course, darling. In one piece. Somewhat shaken and all that, but nothing's out of order, so rest assured.
Where are you calling from now?
Where do you expect? And I have to hang up. I think we're both getting emotional. And anyway, Friday we'll see each other. So long, my love.
Adios, mi amor.
So long.
A very touching scene. But in the end, he will come. And he too will be like the rest of us. I don't want you to pressure him. He will come. But he will come in his own time. And the rest of the month, all we drink is water. But good water, the best in the house. Will that do?
It will do.
Let me tell you this. I don't know why I've got a sensation that's almost a feeling of regret, but still it's a feeling like happiness. That's so intangible, I don't believe it's real.
Is it as if someone came back from the dead?
Yes. You did come back from the dead for me.
Yes, Pablo. But now I'll be with you forever.
Oh, I wish it were true.
Gonna burn up!
Don't cry, Lucita, don't cry. It's all right. See, the nice lady's gonna get the blame. Oh, calm down.
Here, it didn't get burned, see?
Don't say thanks to the lady.
Thank you.
But how? Why did you want to come way out here?
Well, it's also a place that I've been to with you, remember?
Oh, yes, of course.
I want to relive it. Don't you?
But wait.
Do you remember this? Will you keep your word?
Yes, of course. I will now more than ever. Will you?
Now, I've already kept my word, Pablo.
What do you mean, now?
It's the truth, Pablo. I swear it. You see, I'm really dead.
Come on, don't make jokes like that. Not around here.
Haven't I come back as I promised? To prepare you for the hereafter?
Dominique, what's the matter? Are you sick or something?
No, my precious. I feel fine.
Ah, yes. It's all plain now. The accident left an impression, didn't it?
Yes. It was a terrible thing. Inexplicable. In that one moment, I relived all I'd done with you. But that was not all I went through. I was even aware of your despair at the news. I swear it. Why, I could even see you. But that was later.
You could see me?
Yes. And I could hear you. Until I managed to return to you.
Dominique, my poor darling. What is this nonsense?
Simply the truth. And nothing but the truth. Isn't that what they say?
Dominique. I'm going to kiss you. You're not dead, my precious. No more dead than I am. No more than the air we breathe about us. You're just as real as my love. And nothing more real than my love for you could exist. You'll get well. I'll do nothing but take care of you, Dominique. But how can I take care of you if I have to leave medical school before I graduate? What kind of a doctor would I be in that case? Good morning, beautiful.
What time is it?
Does it matter?
Not at all. Time doesn't mean a thing.
I've just received proof that someone I know is a pretty little liar. Lovely to look at, but a bare-faced liar.
Who?
You, that's who. And when I open this, it's the end of your play acting.
Don't be funny. It's advertising.
It's from the airline you flew on. They're not joking. It's a list of survivors I ask for.
Let's not open it.
Ah, I confess that yesterday you were teasing all along, huh? Come on.
Yes, I confess to you. Don't open it.
Oh, vive la différence.
Oh, really?
Now, where would you like to spend the day?
Wherever you like.
No, I'm asking you.
Well, let me think.
While I'm in the shower, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful day. Oh. Dominique, can you hear me?
Yes.
Say, how about a long trip into the country for today? Not a bad idea, huh? We'll make a stop at Segovia. We'll eat delicious trout with white wine, of course, beside some Roman ruins. We'll stop at some inn along the way for the night. Like a pair of pilgrims, visiting a shrine of love where no one will disturb us. And tomorrow we go on our way. Dominique, how about that?
I'm afraid not, Pablo. I have to leave you now.
Dominique, what did you say?
I have to do something.
What did you say, Dominique?
I will explain it to you, Pablo, later on. This afternoon, if you like, I can meet you at our usual place.
Wait a minute, Dominique.
But I can't. I'll see you later on.
Dominique, wait!
Dominique Manso. She was killed. You can see her name for yourself.
You're mistaken. It's not her. It isn't, I swear. It isn't the truth. I know she's not dead, senorita. They've got it confused with one of the other passengers. That's it.
But I'm afraid not, senor. Their identities were double-checked by the authorities from France and Spain.
And I tell you, it's not true what it says there. It isn't the truth. It isn't. It's not true what it says
there. In that case, I'd like you to explain this mystery. If you don't mind, senor, let's talk in my office. I regret the error, if there is one. I realize that to persons like yourself who are affected, it's a terrible thing. I'm sorry, but sometimes these things can't be avoided. If you'll be kind enough to give me all the reasons you have for thinking we are mistaken, then perhaps I'll agree with you. Now, what was the name of the passenger?
Dominique Monceau, from Magon in Brittany.
And you're able, you say, to tell me that this Senorita Monceau is still alive and the same as before?
Yes. Well, she's not the same. She's so strange and so mysterious and such strange coincidences that...
You're saying you've seen her in person since the crash?
Yes.
In Spain?
Mm-hmm.
And there's no possible doubt we certainly have made an error. And yet, according to our records, there was a body identified as Dominique Monceau, which was claimed by French relatives. We must get some explanation. They bury the body tomorrow. But still, according to our records, which I have here, it was taken to a cemetery in northern Brittany, in Agen, where it was claimed from us. We're ready to take any steps you suggest to rectify this tragic mistake.
Please forgive me. Do you understand? No, I'm not feeling too well. Please forgive me. Good afternoon.
The senorita left just now.
Huh? What's that? When?
A little bit ago. But she said to tell you...
Tell me what?
I didn't understand it.
What did she tell you? Think hard.
She said she had to go away someplace far off. Because she has a date that makes her sad. It's for tomorrow.
Where is the date? Where is it?
Well, I can't remember.
Is in France, huh? In Brittany.
That's it, that's it. She said to tell you. Is that in Spain?
No, it's a foreign place.
That's all for
today. See you tomorrow, Professor. Professor Urrutia?
Oh, what a surprise, Pablo. I haven't seen you for ages. Tell me, have you given up your education? Or are you already a doctor?
Well, really, neither one nor the other, Professor. There's a problem with that. Well, can we talk together? It's very important, believe me.
Let me see. This evening? Is that all right?
Well, then, let me give you a lift. We can talk on the way home, Professor.
Well, I suppose it would save time. Why not? Let's go.
Thank you. This is where we're to meet. I wanted to speak to Dominique, to have it out with her once and for all. Not to quarrel, to force her to give me a convincing explanation.
And it was here that you met the boy also?
Yes, at the moment it meant nothing. But afterwards, when I recall that we never met the kid anywhere but at the roadside inn, then his being here struck me as something strange, unnatural.
In my experience so far, I've seen nothing to make me believe in the hereafter. Be that as it may, it would be foolish of scientists and physicians to discount it altogether. An eternal life does exist. It's undoubtedly as real as the life we know as mortals. But as to its nature, the theologians have to be allowed the last word, Pablo, not us physicians.
But you, in a sense, have studied the question for years, Professor. Your hands more than once have felt the balance between life here and the one beyond. I was sure you could tell me.
Those of us who are physicians are more concerned with the matter than with the spirit of man. And when life has departed him, despite what others like to think, he's a mystery to us. And there's really nothing we can assume.
Yet right there on that dance floor, I held a dead girl in my arms. And I swear there was nothing dead about her. This is the earth we held when we first promised each other.
And that earth is the only thing that might yield an explanation.
Really? Why?
Yes, I mean it. Tomorrow, insofar as we know, they're burying Dominique. It would be interesting to find out who that earth is covering, really.
I don't understand.
It's the only way we can ever answer the question, by seeing the corpse with our own eyes. Is the Dominique underneath the ground the Dominique that you knew on Earth?
That was a purpose I had in mind, Professor, but I was afraid you'd resent it.
Is there any possibility of getting there in time?
Yes. I've already bought 2 plane tickets for a flight that leaves tonight.
Good work, Pablo.
Smoke, Professor?
Huh? Oh. Oh, yes, thank
We're going to get there late, Professor.
Wait. I'm afraid we are late. Now, There's nothing to do about it.
Distracted. The one in the tweed coat. I want to speak to her, and I want you to meet her.
Wait, not now. This is hardly the right moment. I'd rather meet her in other surroundings. We'd better go back to the hotel now.
I guess we should. Sorry I made you come all this way for no reason, Professor. The whole thing was just a ridiculous fantasy of my own, or else it was some game of Dominique's.
No, not at all, no. I'm the one you should blame. At my age, one often forgets what it means to be a young man, head over heels in love.
I can't explain this attitude of Dominique's. That's what bothers me most and what I want to clear up as fast as I can.
It's nothing but a passing flight of her imagination. Here in Brittany, the natives are very imaginative. Drawn to apparitions and mystery. Hmm? Look, son. If I were you, I'd draw this conclusion from my experience. I'd go back at once to Madrid and wait there. She's bound to come back, complete with her trousseau and wedding bells in her bonnet. There's no question that one day when you and she are settled down, we'll consider this occasion as utterly ridiculous.
What if she doesn't come back? I don't know what I'd do without her. I'd go out of my mind.
She's the world to you, is that right?
Yes. And she's my being. But why bother to ask?
Sometimes it's not wise to love too much. Do you understand? It's not wise to be obsessed. That is, to the point where no one else exists.
That's how it is, Professor. For me, the only one who exists is Dominique. I love her. Is that a bad thing?
I'm afraid so.
No, I won't go back to Madrid before I have a chance to talk to her.
Pablo. I want to ask you one more question. You're a good man if you're man enough to be honest and give me a sincere answer.
Hmm. Every now and then, I wonder if I am.
All right, what would you think of me if I said that today in the cemetery with you, I was unable to see Dominique?
I'd say in all sincerity, you must be blind, or else you must be crazy.
And if I could guarantee you that I'm in full possession of my senses, and that both of my eyes are completely normal, and I didn't see her.
Well, in that case, I'd say I ought to see a doctor, because Dominique was as plain as day.
Indeed? Are you sure?
You don't mean that seriously.
Pablo, you came to me and asked if I would help. That's what I want to do. Believe me.
I'm not crazy and you know it. I saw her. And tonight I'm going to see her again, Professor.
Somewhere along the line, there's been a mistake. At the hotel, I was given the address of this house. Obviously, the place is deserted.
Ah, it's been deserted a long time now. The Monceaux all died out many years ago.
Did you say the Monceaux?
Yes, that's right.
In that case, this morning at the cemetery, who were the people who came to the funeral of a young girl named Dominique?
They're another branch, a distant one. And their name is Monceaux, the people of Lyons. All they wanted was to see the funeral of the poor young lady. What with her being the very last of the true Monceaux, but those people already left town.
But don't they own part of this house and share it?
It's still assigned to the others, the true Monceaux. They set aside money in a fund to keep it up indefinitely. I ought to know, because I'm the caretaker, but now I'm old and feeble and no one wants to help me because the pay is pretty poor, you know.
Well, isn't there an administrator? I think he might give me the information I'm looking for.
The best information I know already, and there's nothing else possible to learn or know from anybody. When the administrator appears, I get my pay and he goes away, someplace or other. He's a strange man, and I don't ask him.
Yes. Well, thank you. Indeed, you've been most helpful. Good afternoon.
Pleasure to talk to you.
I'm glad to hear it, but you're too kind. It's flattering to be recognized far away from home. Well, really, could you tell me what possibility there is of getting an order for the exhumation of a cadaver? Yes, of course. The request is a professional one. Ah, yes. The name is Monceaux. Dominique Monceaux, yes.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Is Senorita Dominique Monceaux here?
Please come in if you will.
Thank you.
This way, please.
Thank you.
Mademoiselle Claude Legrand and her sister, Madame Dominique Monceau.
Pablo Velasco.
You must really be cold. Some cognac?
Why, yes, that's very kind of you.
Please make yourself comfortable.
My son, Jacques.
How do you do?
How do you do?
We're delighted to meet you and have you with us. Dominique has told us so much about you and her.
And we've all been expecting you.
You were expecting me?
Of course. It's only natural, isn't it? It was in my time. A polite young man asked for daughter's hand.
Of course. Of course.
Even though it means nothing to Dominique, the rest of us have always thought of it as ordinary good manners. It's a family custom.
In fact, you should. I quite agree you should. I'll tell you what my intentions are. I know she's willing to marry me, and I intend to marry Dominique. I would like very much, though, to have you give us your consent and blessing.
But of course I shall give it, and with all my heart. Dominique is so enthralled with you that...
That it is only a point of etiquette to give formal consent to you. Her happiness, and yours as well, depend on your knowing us.
Don't think it strange, brother-in-law. The Monceaux of Brittany have always been known for being perfectly happy together.
All of them. Except your father. Poor man. He didn't want to have anything to do with our reunions here.
My husband was a peculiar man. And he alone didn't share our interests. He grew to hate them.
But why?
He was scared of the supernatural world. Isn't that silly?
Mama, I believe we should all go into dinner now. It's time, don't you think?
Oh, yes. Yes, shall we go in? Pablo must sit opposite me at the head of the table. After all, he's our guest of honor.
Thank you.
Yes, you may begin to serve the soup now, Marius.
Not any to me, Marius. I'd rather save my appetite for the main course. I can't resist mallard, duck, and orange. Can you, Pablo?
You can be frank, brother-in-law. If you don't care for the mallard, Marius can serve you anything you like.
Oh, no. I'm really very fond of it. But you mean that we're not waiting for Dominique?
She's resting in bed. She was indisposed this morning.
Yes, this morning. She told us she must have a complete rest.
I'm afraid tonight she has to stay upstairs.
Watch what you're doing, Marius. Why, you fill this plate to overflowing.
Will you tell us your age, Pablo?
22.
Well, mine is a secret, but I can easily imagine the way you would shudder if you ask and I told you what it is.
But then my sister hates and despises time and his brother, the calendar. She also thinks that time is an invention of foolish men.
And so it is. No doubt about it. I think the wine will please you. As a Burgundy, it's magnificent. Marius, serve him some wine at once.
No, you needn't pour it, Marius. I'll pour myself a glass.
I think I should...
Of course you'll spend the night here with us. You can't go on a night like this.
I'll come back tomorrow morning.
No. I insist tonight you stay here with us. As you can see, the house is much too large just for the four of us. What's the matter? Aren't you thrilled at the idea of staying so near to Dominique?
If you're ready. In Brittany, we count the days when the sun shines. We have a higher incidence of fog than anywhere else in Europe.
So I've heard. I suppose that accounts for its reputation for necromancy and witchcraft. I forget who told me that in Brittany some of the dead live just like we do.
This is your room. I have already told Marius to light a fire for you. I'll say goodnight to you now, if everything is all right.
I'll be quite all right, thanks. Dominique? Dominique? Dominique Monceau.
passed away from injuries in an automobile wreck on the 5th of August in the year of our Lord, 1944. Claude Legrand passed away in an accident while hunting the 6th of May in the year of our Lord, 1947. Killed in action, Jacques Monceau passed away from wounds received the 9th of January, 1945.
Dominique Monceau passed away in a plane crash the 12th of December, 1965.
Dominique, you can't pretend to me. All this is a joke, an absurd joke. You're playing a trick.
Pablo, don't you see that it's natural?
Natural? That I went to dinner with your dead relatives? Natural that you made me think you're keeping our promise?
Aren't you glad that I did?
Oh, are you in love with me or not, Dominique? You're destroying my patience, my sanity. I almost wish that family of yours were dead.
But they're not playing. You're convinced, Pablo. You can see that it's true, can't you, that I'm really dead? You read my name there, on the list of the victims of the accident. But still, you were able to go on loving
me. Once and for all, Dominique, hush. I couldn't possibly think of you as dead. Tell me that you're alive. For my sake.
I'm alive for you. But you have to live the same way for me. We swore to that.
I adore you. Come on, Dominique. Let's get out of here. Let's forget we were ever in Brittany at all. You'll be all right in Spain. Let's get out of this mist and go into the sunshine.
No, Pablo, dearest. Neither one of us can go back again. My precious, we must stay as we are forever in Brittany. You want me at your side, don't you? Here we live beyond the mortal limits of life on Earth. We're beyond death.
That isn't love, Dominique. It's an infatuation with eternity.
Yes, eternity. That's just what I'm offering you, my love. We'll be each other's eternal being.
Then set me free, Dominique. If you want to live forever in a shroud, then go ahead. Stay here with these ghosts of yours. Go on, love a dead man. But don't let that man be me. Take any man but me.
This is a most surprising reaction. But really, I see from your face that you have had a change of heart, brother-in-law. I suppose he has told you, my late lamented sister, that he asked for your hand and we gave our consent. The Monceau's habits are somewhat antique ones, traditional, I'd say. We keep our word, young man, and with a fidelity that is unquestionable, especially proposals, and we are prepared to hold you to what you promised us.
No one can be held to a promise that's impossible.
That's impossible. What are you referring to?
It's plain enough what I'm referring to. You're people who are dead. So you tell me, how can you expect me to keep my promise to marry a dead person?
Pablo, what's the matter? The idea distresses you. Though why, I can't imagine. No one is demanding the impossible here. Because you are a corpse like the rest of us. What I mean is, you are one of us. Or are you really unaware that you have been dead since 9 o'clock? You died of heart failure during dinner with us tonight. It was too much of a shock for you when you saw Dominique.
Let me out of here! Let me out of here!
Calm yourself, Pablo. Calm yourself. All that Jacques has told you is the truth. You are no longer alive. Or rather, I should tell you, you have begun to live another life that's different from the one you lived away from us. The life of the dead. The one we lead.
You'll like it a lot better, dearest Pablo. Now nothing can ever separate you from Meek. You will live with her, a story of love. One that will be marvelous and everlastingly true. The most romantic of all stories. One I envy you both. That's why I'm quite sure of your happiness.
No, I won't let you make me a lunatic. I know you're all crazy, but don't look at me. I'm not crazy. You try to hinder me and I show you I'm not. I can tell. It's all preposterous. Yes, how could I be dead and still feel my heart beating? My senses are working. It's all preposterous. You see, I can breathe and think. You can't stop me from going. Because I can shout.
But no one can hear you outside. Your voice no longer makes a sound except when you talk to us. Your real body no longer moves like this except when you walk with us. Because you're a dead man. Because to those who have yet to pass on, your real body has another configuration, another aspect entirely, another dimension to them. Do you want to be convinced, brother-in-law? If I put out the light, you'll see the reflection before you as if in a mirror of what you look like now to the outside world. I hate to do this to you.
I once saw you put your hand in the fire without burning it, Dominique. You can because you're dead, but I can't. And I'm going to prove it to you once and for all that I'm alive!
I heard a scream from inside the house.
I heard it too, but...
Come on, let's not waste time arguing. From the way it sounded, the scream came from upstairs somewhere. What's up there?
That is where the family bedrooms and the library are.
Yourself. I'm sorry for you, my dear brother-in-law.
Take it easy, Pablo.
It's a shame to leave us now, Pablo. We were all so pleased to have you with us. But you will come back. You really will come back, Pablo. Of course you will.
Don't be too long, my precious. I'll be waiting for you. I'll be waiting. I'll be waiting.
My dear brother-in-law, it's not possible for you to live unless you live with us. We arranged for you to come of your own free will. You brought it on yourself. I'm sorry for you, my dear brother-in-law.
It's a shame to leave us now, Pablo. We were always so pleased to have you with us. We'll see you soon.
Don't be too long, my love. I'll be waiting for you. I'll be waiting.
You must believe me, Professor. I swear it's the truth. You must believe me. It's as true as the fact that I'm talking to you now.
I believe you, Pablo. I believe you. Now you just relax. You're safe and sound. I'll go out and get a sedative to make you sleep a little.
Don't leave me here. Don't leave me.
I won't.
I'm afraid of Dominique. I'm afraid of her, Professor. I'm afraid.
Don't worry.
But I'll love her as long as I live.
There's nothing to fear. We're leaving tomorrow. Get a good night's sleep now and you'll feel better. Let me see if there's something here. Here, drink this for now.
Yes, I want to sleep. Relax.
That's it.
I must sleep.
Good, good. Relax now.
Call me Pop.
Pablo.
Thank you.
What do you expect to find in there, Professor?
A woman who's dead. A woman who's dead and buried.